This video will describe a simplified pelvic organ prolapse quantification exam technique. This technique is very similar to that used for the POP-Q exam, except that it will require only taking four measures and will not require the recording of centimeters, but only ordinal stages. The four points to be measured are the anterior vaginal wall, the posterior vaginal wall, the vaginal apex or posterior fornix, and the non-hysterectomized patient. The point representing the anterior vaginal wall will be a point or rugal fold roughly 3 centimeters proximal to the urethral meatus, point A in this diagram. The point representing the posterior vaginal wall will be a point or rugal fold roughly 3 centimeters proximal to the hymeneal remnants on the posterior vaginal wall, or point B in this diagram. The point representing the cervix will be the anterior lip of the cervix, point C in this diagram, and the point representing the atex will be the posterior fornix or cuff scar in a hysterectomized patient, represented as point D in this diagram. The stages then are described in relation to the hymeneal remnants. Stage 1 is prolapse that remains at least 1 centimeter above the hymeneal remnants. Stage 2 is prolapse that descends to the hymeneal remnants, defined as 1 centimeter above or 1 centimeter past the hymeneal remnants. Stage 3 is prolapse that descends greater than 1 centimeter past the hymeneal remnants, but does not represent complete vaginal vault eversion or complete procedentia. And stage 4 is the complete vaginal vault eversion or complete uterine procedentia. The secret to understanding the staging system is to remember stage 2. Stage 2 has the point being measured in between 1 centimeter above or 1 centimeter below the hymeneal remnants, as noted in this box in the diagram. If the point being measured remains 1 centimeter proximal to this box, then it is stage 1. If it descends to within this box, it is stage 2. If it descends past this box, it's stage 3. And then if there is complete eversion or procedentia, it's stage 4. Remember, if the anterior vaginal wall, posterior vaginal wall, or any of the points are stage 4, they are all stage 4, because by definition, that is complete procedentia. These next two slides represent several examples of the simplified POP-Q stages. In the example on the left, all four points remain at least 1 centimeter above the hymeneal remnants. All four points are stage 1. In the box on the right, the anterior vaginal wall point descends to stage 2, that is 1 centimeter above or 1 centimeter below the hymeneal remnants. The other three points are stage 1. This slide represents stage 3 and stage 4 prolapse. In the box on the left, the anterior vaginal wall descends greater than 1 centimeter past the hymeneal remnants, which is stage 3. The cervix actually descends to within a centimeter of the hymen and is stage 2. The posterior fornix and the posterior vaginal wall are both stage 1. And in the example on the right, all four points are stage 4, as this represents complete uterine procedentia. Next, we will present several exams. The first thing to determine prior to initiating an exam is to identify a 3 centimeter distance on your index finger. This is done here using a wooden pap smear spatula that has been marked in centimeters. I have identified that the distal segment of my index finger measures approximately 3 centimeters. Next, a disarticulated Graves speculum, a sim speculum can also be used, is placed in the vagina and the posterior vaginal wall is retracted. The hymeneal remnants are identified converging at the external urethral meatus, as demonstrated by the wooden spatula. I then use my index finger to identify a point on the anterior vaginal wall that is roughly 3 centimeters proximal to the urethral meatus. The subject is then asked to Valsalva or coughed, and where that point descends in relation to the hymen is noted. In this instance, it stays well above the hymeneal remnants or remains greater than 1 centimeter above the hymen and is therefore stage 1. The disarticulated speculum is then used to retract the anterior vaginal wall, and the posterior segment is examined in a similar fashion. Often the hymeneal remnants are less prominent posteriorly, but they can be imagined and are felt to be here, as demonstrated by the wooden spatula. With the patient performing a Valsalva, it can be noted that there is minimal descent and the area remains greater than 1 centimeter above the hymeneal remnants, so again, this is stage 1. To describe the stage of the apex or the cuff in this patient, as she is status post hysterectomy, one finger is inserted into the vagina until the tip touches the cuff. The patient then valsalvas and coughs, and where that apex descends in relation to the hymen is recorded. This is done by noting where the cup descends against your fingertip and then placing your thumb along your finger at the level of the hymeneal remnants. When you remove your finger from the vagina, it can be seen that the patient's cup remained at least 5 to 6 centimeters above the hymen, which again represents stage 1. In the next example, again, the first thing to do is to determine a 3 centimeter distance on your index finger. Again, this is done using a wooden spatula. The disarticulated Graves speculum is then placed in the vagina and the posterior wall is retracted. The hymeneal remnants are less well defined in this subject, but can be imagined again converging at the external urethral meatus as demonstrated by the spatula. I then use my finger to identify the point on the anterior vaginal wall that will be recorded, and we have the patient call for Valsalva. In this subject, the point descends roughly to the hymeneal remnants. Therefore, this patient has stage 2 anterior support. The disarticulated speculum is then used to retract the anterior vaginal wall, and the posterior segment is examined in a similar fashion. Often again, the hymeneal remnants are less prominent, but they can be imagined here. The posterior vaginal wall moves very little with this patient performing cough and Valsalva and remains greater than 1 centimeter above the hymeneal remnants, so this is stage 1. Again, to describe the apex, one finger is inserted up to the cuff, as this patient also has had a hysterectomy. The patient is asked to cough and Valsalva, where the apex descends in relation to the hymen is recorded, again by placing a thumb up against the index finger at the level of the hymeneal remnants, period. In this patient, it can be seen that the cuff remains at least 6 to 7 centimeters above the hymen and is stage 1.